as a woman, whenever you masturbate, it's funny, yeah. Whenever you masturbate, you're like, you know those parts of your body that you enjoy. So you can be able to communicate with your man, with your partner. Hello, valuers. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me on today's episode. I am your host, Mary Jensen Amy. And if today is your first time of coming across this valuable face, I want to say thank you so much for joining me to this episode. And please, you consider subscribing, like, share, and make this home your home. And to you, my great supporters, I want to say thank you so much for growing with me. Just as you all can see from the title, masturbation is self-love. What do you think about that? Do you think masturbation is self-love? There was a video that I watched, although there is a story that actually made me decide to just bring up this video. But I watched a video where someone was saying masturbation is self-love. That is you knowing yourself, is you understanding yourself. Masturbation is you as a woman being in charge of your body. As a woman, whenever you masturbate, it's funny, yeah. Whenever you masturbate, you're like, you know those parts of your body that you enjoy. So you can be able to communicate with your man, with your partner, and say, okay, yeah, this spot is actually where I love you to do this, or this is what I want you to do, or that. You know, this is a serious issue. So that's why I decide to bring it up here. Remember in my channel, if you can check, I talk about love affairs. So these things, they are tutorials that will help us in our marriages, in our relationship as people. So do you think masturbation is self-love? Before I will say what I think personally, you just, you know, put it down in the comment section and let me know what you think about masturbation. Is it self-love? When I masturbate, when I go into the bathroom and I masturbate, do you think it's because I love myself so much? There are some ladies that said, oh, I don't need a man for anything in my life. I can just use cucumber, for example, and do this. And this is not a joke. People do it because someone shared a story with me. The reason I'm making this video is because a lady actually reached out to me. And yes, before I share some of their stories, they give me the permission. So she said, when she was young, she masturbates and she feels so good about it. So she doesn't feel like, okay, I need a man to do this for me to feel like a woman. So she does it and she's okay all by herself. Now, she's married, okay? She's married with her family, with her children. Now that she's married, she now still found out that no matter what her husband does, she still feels like, if I don't masturbate, like, it is not there. And sometimes she masturbates and when the husband comes, she is not desiring the husband, like she doesn't want the husband, and this has been causing problem. Maybe the husband has been thinking that, oh, does it mean I'm not good for you? What is it that I'm not doing right? What is it? But she said that as for her, that she has gotten so used to, you know, her getting that pleasure by herself. So she just goes in and then she does one or two things to herself and she feels, wow, relaxed. And as for her, she has seen that it has been, you know, troubling her marriage and she sincerely need help. And I'm also making this video, if you're watching me and there's any advice you have, although we've talked, but if there's any advice you have for such person, I would love you to, you know, write it down in the comment section, because she would be at the comment section reading messages, okay? Although yes, this will be a premiere, but even after watching the premiere, you can still drop, you know, one or two advice or help in the comment section so she can come back later to read. So as I was saying, she said as for now that she herself, she knows that this is not helping her, it's not helping her marriage, it's making her husband feel as if, you know, all he has been doing, he has not been doing enough. He's making her husband feel like, oh, does it mean I'm not satisfying you, or why don't you want me? And that's why she said that when she finishes it, she does not even want the husband. She can stay for weeks without even desiring it because she gets and satisfies herself. She gets and she satisfies herself. So what do you think about such people? For me personally, I'm not here to judge anybody, okay? No, because that's not what I'm here doing. I'm not here to judge anybody. I won't say she is wrong. I won't call her name. No, you know, let me just say she has done what she did and today it is not favoring her anymore. And she needs help. And that help is what we are here to do. For me, masturbation, I don't see it as a self love at all. I don't see it. Why should I go and start doing stuff with my body and I will say it is self-love? For me, it doesn't make sense. For me, oh, so I know some people, they'll be like, ah, Mary, this, we are entitled to our own opinion. So for me, it doesn't make any sense. I don't see it lawful. I don't see it good. Why should I touch myself, masturbate myself to feel happy and then I'll feel like, oh, wow, yes. For me, it doesn't make any sense. Why should I do that? So I'm here to tell those young ladies that have, you know, decided to just settle down with, you know, masturbating and that you think is good, you really have to think about what you are doing and know if this is really what you want for yourself, because one can get addicted to some things, and by the time you want to come out of it, just like this woman, it becomes difficult. Or even though you don't want to come out of it, it will affect your relationship, it will affect your life in one way or the other. So before you get addicted to anything, please make sure this is not something that will consume you negatively. It's not something that you regret. And there are some things that when they hook you, coming out of it is so difficult, because as for her, she's not saying that she's not enjoying it. She's enjoying it. But it is that her marriage is actually, you know, suffering it. And she really wants to, you know, try sometimes not to do it so she can actually satisfy the man, because she's no longer opening her body, you know, giving her body freely for the husband. So I would like to advise, with all due respect, so many things are just going on. You see some people, like I say, they use cucumber, they use this, they use that, you know, to satisfy themselves. Most people, they think that, oh, I don't need a man again. What do I need a man for? Is it just for the satisfaction? I can get it, you know, if I need it, I can satisfy myself and all of that. So she was not asking me, is it wrong? Is it a sin? What do you people think in the comment section? Just tell me, do you think masturbation is a sin? Do you think it is self-love? Do you think it is right? Do you think it is okay by God? Do you think, oh, God doesn't, God is not worrying himself whether you masturbate or not? What do you think about it? For me, oh, I won't advise anyone that I love to, you know, have it as a habit. I wouldn't advise anyone to put it on as a lifestyle, masturbating, you know, to satisfy yourself. If you're a woman and you are married, this is me, why don't you just go to your husband and then get all of those satisfaction, because God has made it so. He knows why he made it so. So if he had wanted us to masturbate, then he would have just only created Adam, and then Eve wouldn't come into the picture. Then Adam would have masturbated and, you know, satisfy himself, because there is no Eve to help him. But because this life we have male, female, we should always try as much as we can to do things the right way. This is my opinion. So for me, masturbation is not self-love. You don't masturbate and tell you it's because you love yourself. No, it's because you actually misinterpreted the meaning of love. What is love? What is love? Love is purity. And what you are doing, is it pure? Do you think what you're doing is pure for yourself? For me, I see it as a dirty stuff. I'm sorry to use that word, but for me, I see it as a dirty stuff. So masturbation is not self-love. I'm making this video to, you know, tell people that I think, oh, I can masturbate, it's my body, it's my life, I do it to feel good about myself, it's self-love. No one can. For me, it is not self-love. It is just a misconception. So we have to get it right and know that no matter how you masturbate, no matter how you think self-love, you can never get that satisfaction that you will get when you actually meet the opposite sex, whether you're a man or a woman. So what do you think in the comment section? Just let me know what you think in the comment section. But as for her, I told her that she should try as much as she can to resist it. When she feels that urge of masturbating, let her go to her husband. Call your husband and tell your husband. Or, if possible, you can confide in your husband. So my advice for that, such anyone, if you're watching and know you're experiencing such thing, confide in your husband. And if he's an understanding husband that actually has the best interest of you at heart, he would help you out. Whenever you need it, you go to him and he will help you. Because masturbating would actually kill that desire of even wanting to have any, you know, intercourse with your husband, or with your wife, because you feel like, oh, I can just go into the bathroom with my cucumber, with this and that, and satisfy myself. So make sure you carry your couple along. And for me, like I say, masturbation is not self-love. I won't advise anyone to masturbate. So try as much as you can to stop doing it, in as much as habit is so difficult for you to just withdraw. You can do it together with your spouse, okay? And I know it is not something that will just happen like this. It will take time, but you put in effort. When that urge comes, try not to do it yourself, but try to go to your partner. And also, I believe that in everything, prayer works. So if you are such that you are trapped in that, you know, self-love, masturbation, try as much as you can to pray. I believe that the Holy Spirit will always help us out of every predicament, out of every problem, no matter how difficult it is, He would help us out. So commit it in the hands of God. Pray. No matter what you go through, no matter the challenges, He will always give you the strength to come out as a winner, as a champion. So many people have actually gone through worse things and today they are standing. So I believe you too, you can also stand if you believe in yourself, if you trust in God, if you commit it in His hand, and you also walk towards it. Like, it is one thing for you to desire something, and it's also another thing for you to put in effort in achieving that thing. So I would say it all lies in your hands. Pray, put in effort, just believe in God. When that urge comes, because it will come for you to do it for yourself, try to subdue it. Go to your partner, talk to him, speak to her, understand each other, and get that satisfaction from the right way. People that are not yet married that masturbate, for me, I don't know, it's like you are degrading your body. You don't value yourself, because if you value yourself, you wouldn't do such impurity to yourself. So this is actually what I've come here to share, and I'm saying that masturbation is not self-love. It is not self-love. So tell me what you think in the comment section below. Just let us know what you think, because this is what I think, and she will also be reading. Like I've said, prayer is the most important thing. There is nothing prayer cannot do, but even as you pray, you should be willing to put in effort, because don't just pray and say, hey, I feel like, then you go and do. You feel good? No. Make sure even as you pray, you also put in effort. Be intentional about the change you want. So yes, this brings us to the end of this video. If you like this video, you please, you know, like, share, subscribe, and you know, turn on your post notification icon till I come your way next time. Remember that you are the head and not the tail. I remain your humble host, Mary Jensen Emmy.